continues tonight at UCF as a recruiting scandal unfolds.
Athletic director Keith Tribble has resigned, and the head basketball coach Donnie Jones has been suspended for 3 games for alleged NCAA violations.
WESH 2 has live team coverage. Pat Clark has breaking comments from Donnie Jones, but we start with Bob Keeling live at UCF. And Bob, you were the first to speak with football coach George O'Leary today, and Bob, he says he's running a clean program.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, he did say that he reminded his coaches and players that recruiting is a big money business and they have to know what's right and wrong of these latest allegations, as well as ones from the past. He's confident those are isolated.
And our program, as far as football is concerned, is a clean program.
Coach George O'Leary says he didn't become aware of these latest alleged violations until the NCAA came calling. Investigators say a middleman for a pro sports agency may have made impermissible contact and paid more than $15,000 in benefits to 11 prospective UCF recruits, 6 basketball, 5 in football.
My same message is to the coaches and the players that, you know, we do things by the rule book, and, you know, recruiting is a business, but, you know, there's a correct way to do some things and not correct. And
it's dollar driven. You put a dollar sign next to everything in the NCAA now. A lot of money to be made out there.
This former UCF player says the trend in college sports is for recruiters to follow ever younger talent.
It's the nature of the game. You have to recruit these players now to get them when they're seniors.
UCF is already on NCAA probation after a former coach on O'Leary's staff made improper cell phone contacts with young prospects.
Coach, we had the cell phone issue. Now this, do you look back in retrospect and say, should I be running a tighter ship?
No, I think they're isolated incidents.
A UCF spokesman says they have no issue with how O'Leary is handling the program.
We addressed those people who were named in this report. Coach O'Leary was not.
So now UCF has 90 days to respond to these latest allegations, and because they're already on probation, they're seen as a repeat offender, so they could be subject to enhanced sanctions. But that spokesman tells me that the university plans to come up with their own proposed self-imposed discipline, so we'll have to see how that plays itself out. Reporting live from UCF, I'm Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News. We could